Hey guys, it's Lily Pad Polish, and in today's video, I'm going to be showing you guys how to create this super Christmassy manicure. So this is a really just simple, cozy type of Christmas manicure. We got a little plaid going on, a little Christmas wreath. It's pretty simple and it's pretty easy to recreate. So if you guys are interested in knowing how I created this manicure, then just keep on watching. So starting off, as always, I'm going to be applying my base coat to protect my nails and ensure that this manicure lasts as long as possible. So I'm going to be using the Holo Taco Long Lasting Base Coat, and I'm just applying a fairly thin and even layer on all of my nails. I actually did get a comment on a recent video about how I get my manicures to last so long. So hopefully I'll be filming that in the near future, because I do have some little tips and tricks that I do to make my manicure last a fairly long time without getting any chipping or peeling of my manicure. So if you guys are interested in that, definitely let me know, but I think I will be filming that in the near future, hopefully next year. But yes, so definitely let me know if that's something that you guys are interested in watching as well. But once my base coat was dry, I went in with all of my base colors. So this first one is a sort of jade green color. This is a nail polish from OPI. I can't exactly remember the name of it off the top of my head, but I'll have all of the nail polish and tools that I'm using throughout this video in the link, or not in the link, in the description box below. I'll have all the links down there. So I'm applying this jade green color on my pointer finger and then also on my pinky fingernail. So this is going to just be the base of our plaid design. So I'm just applying an even layer. Here in the video, I'm only showing you guys me applying the first coat, but off camera I did apply a second and even a third coat, and this applies for all of the colors. I just like a fairly thick manicure personally. And then for the white, we're only applying this on our middle fingernail, so the white will be the base for our wreath. I just wanted to have a light base so that the wreath sort of pops on the nail. So I'm applying an even layer of this, of course, and I'm pretty sure this is just the Sally Hansen Extreme Wear nail polish that I'm using. I don't always use the most pigmented whites, but a couple of coats will make it look just perfect. So I don't really mind using a sheer white polish. And then for my ring fingernail, I'm using Holo Taco's Red Licorice, I think it's called. It's their red holographic polish. And I just thought that it would be the perfect base. So this is the only nail that will not have any design on it. I just wanted to add red to this manicure just to make all of the Christmas colors come together. So we have like the red, green, and the white. So yeah, I will be adding glitter over top of this, but this will be our fairly simple nail. And I actually did the same thing to my thumbnail. So as you can see, I am just applying a red glitter over top of this. This is a super old nail polish, but I use it almost every Christmas because it is the perfect red glittery polish. As you can see, it has red glitters in it, but it actually has a couple of silver specks of glitter throughout as well, and it just is so Christmassy to me. But once I was finished applying that, I went in and made a sheer black polish. So if you already have one, like a jelly black polish, this will work too, but I ended up just using an old base coat that I never used, nor did I like, so I didn't mind wasting it. And I just little by little put tiny droplets of black polish to create my own sheer black polish. So there's many ways that you can do a plaid manicure. You can also do the opposite, where if you have a sheer or jelly red polish, you can do that as well, and you can apply it over just straight black. But this is the route that I chose. I just chose to make my own sheer black polish and then do the plaid designs that way. So the look that we're trying to go for is sort of a layered look, which is why I wanted it to look sheer. So I'm just applying two horizontal lines on my nail, and I'm going to draw one vertical line sort of to the side of my nail. And so I'm just making the lines fairly thick. I do not want them thin at all, because we are going to go in with thin lines with different colors. So we're going for like that buffalo plaid type of design, and then I just made my vertical line to sort of intersect the horizontal lines. And then once I was done with that, I went in with straight black and made little squares where the lines intersected so that it looks more layered, because obviously the layered parts would be darker. And then once I did that, I went in with a thin nail art brush and some red acrylic paint to make the intersecting lines across the black ones. It's sort of hard to explain how you do a plaid design, but if you just watch and copy, that's basically just what I did. I just used a picture and just sort of copied it because I knew I was gonna mess it up otherwise. But yeah, it's pretty simple if you just have like a reference to look at. So I was just making my red lines, trying to make them as thin as I can. They actually ended up being a little thicker than I wanted them to, but that is a-okay. And then the last color that we're gonna go in with is actually a glitter. So I have this gold glitter from a China Glaze Stripe Bright polish that I had. So that ended up working out perfectly. If you don't have a glitter striper, you can always just go in with a regular gold, or you can even just plop it out on a piece of paper and then use a nail art brush to make those thinner lines. And then I did get a little messy while doing this design, so I just went in and cleaned them up. So our next design will be our wreath on the middle fingernail. So what I did first is going in with green acrylic paint. I just did my four lines and then I just connect them all together, and this is just the perfect way to get an even circle. That's how I like to do it, and it always comes out pretty decent. I mean, like, that's a pretty nice looking circle if you ask me. So that's just a little trick to get your circle not be an oval. And then I just went in and did like sort of little V's all around to start making the like feathery leaves around the wreath. And then once I had a good base for that, I just went in and outlined the circle one more time just to thicken it up. And then I went in and added some more feathery lines wherever I felt it needed more, just to thicken up the wreath and make it look more fluffier. And I did the same on the inner part of the circle as well as the outer part of the circle. And then once I was happy with that, I went in with some red acrylic paint and I just made a little bow on the top. So I wanted it to be sort of tiny and delicate. And actually off camera, I did go in with the gold that we previously used, and I made a dot in the middle just so it looks more put together. But as you can see here, I also just made dots to make it look like the little cherries, or I don't know, are they cherries? What do you call those red dots on a wreath? But yeah, I added that and then just went in with white to make it look like it has a little bit of snow on it. And that is literally all for this manicure. So once it was 110% dry, I went in with my Holo Taco super glossy top coat. So I just went over the entire manicure and made sure to cap the edges for a longer lasting manicure. And I actually went in with a second coat of this top coat off camera, especially for the glitter manicure, just to make sure that my nails weren't rough or bumpy at all. I do like my nails to be nice and smooth so that the glitter doesn't end up chipping at all. So once I was done with that, our manicure is all complete. I really, really love the way that this turned out. It is so Christmassy to me. It's like a classic Christmas manicure. You can always just go without the plaid and just do the wreath on the middle finger, or you can just do the plaid without the wreath. I just kind of wanted to put these two designs together. One, because I felt like it goes well together, but two, just to give you guys some more ideas so you have two designs to take from, so you can mix and match whichever way you'd like. But I really hope that you guys enjoyed this tutorial. I do plan on making one more Christmas manicure before the year ends, so hopefully I'll be able to get that out for you guys by Christmas Eve, crossing my fingers. But I really hope that you guys enjoyed this video, and if you did, I would love it if you gave it a thumbs up, and definitely subscribe for more videos like this one if you haven't already. So thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in my next one soon. Bye.